been the one get RP up on a wifey. Keep my hands clean, got some hitters moving shiesty. Ask me if I'm rolling with some Gucci, bitch, I might. When they say I'm not hot, all these lies need to stop. When they say I'm not hot, all these lies need to stop. When they say I'm not hot, all these lies need to stop. When they say I'm not hot, all these lies need to stop. When they say I'm not hot,
what?
Say I'm not hot,
what?
Need to stop. They say I'm not hot,
what?
When they say I'm not hot, all these lies need to stop.
Above all, love each other deeply because love covers a multitude of sins. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So as you can see by the title, I'm going to be doing a date night inspired look for you guys. My eyebrows have already been done off camera and I'm going to be priming my eyelids with NC40 concealer in MAC and setting that with Sasha Buttercup powder. So using the shades in the highlighted box, I'm going to start off with the pinkish lighter tones and I'm going to be putting that in my crease. I'm going to be blending it out in circular motions. I'm then going to go in with my darker shades or the brown tone shades and I'm going to be putting it into the outer view of my eyelid. So this is literally at the corner, guys. Go in light handed, guys, because the darker shades tend to be the harder shades to blend out. So you don't want to have to build up to tear down. Just build up gradually until you're satisfied with the result. So using the shades in the highlighted boxes, I'm going to be doing the same as I did before. I'm going to be blending out in the outer V and also in the crease area just to soften the look as well. I'm going to also take a clean brush and just make everything to merge together, make everything look seamless and perfect. So I'm going to be taking my flat definer brush and I'm going to be dipping that into some light concealer. I actually don't know where I got this brush from, guys, but there's a lot of brush options out there just depending on how comfortable you are with cutting creases. The bigger you go, the more comfortable you are. So if you start at first, you should go with like a smaller brush just to get the definition at A1 before you go into bigger brushes. I'm then going to go in with an eyeshadow on the palette that I showed you guys in the beginning. I'm just gonna set that like straight away. I don't want to have any transfer, make everything look messy. I want everything to be neat and seamless. So I'm going to be taking this wing liner, guys. This liner is absolutely amazing for the price and the product, A1. So yeah, I'm going to be creating like a really natural wing, nothing too dramatic because at the end of the day we're trying to accentuate our natural beauty, not hide it. I'm going to be grabbing my glitter liner. This liner is amazing also. I'm going to be putting above where I cut the crease, so you'll see in a second I'm also going in the light manner. You don't want it to be too thick because it takes away from the actual cut crease, so make sure you're going in a light manner just above the cut crease. I'm going to be taking my foundation. I'm going to be applying the foundation with my flat concealer brush. The reason why I do it like this is because I want to get like an even amount of foundation on both sides of my face. Like, it's just easier for me this way and it makes everything just so much more easier when it comes to the blending out process. Taking my concealer and I'm going to be putting it on all the places where the light hits the most. So this is underneath my eye, around my mouth, on my forehead, just where you prefer to put it. You can even put it underneath your contour. I'm also going to be sharing a top secret with you guys. This is what I do to achieve my flawless outcome. Like, I kid you not, this step, if anything you take out from this video, it has to be this step. And make sure when you do it, you message me and tell me your results because I really want to know if it works for other people. My top secret is I set my concealer. So in a second, you're going to be seeing me fanning my face. So I let it dry to like a semi-dry consistency, then I blend it out. So this gives me like a really flawless, flawless outcome. Like, literally, I've never turned back after using this step. Next, I'm going to be taking my Sasha Buttercup powder and I'm going to be putting that all over my face. I don't know about you guys, but this is actually my shade. And if it looks a bit ashy, I will go in with some blush and just darken up the places where it needs to be darkened. So you can see I'm especially putting that on the highlighted areas. So I would focus the powder on the highlighted areas. And that's me being silly. And yeah. So I'm going to be taking my blush and I'm going to be bringing back some warmth to my face. This blush is amazing, and also this highlight is a 10 out of 10. I'm going to be going a bit overboard, but not too overboard. I just want to glow, sis. We need to glow for this day, okay? So I'm going to be applying my eyelashes off camera, and I'm going to be doing my signature look. If you know me, you know this is a step I always take. So I'm going to be taking that collection silver liner that I used earlier on in the video, and I'm going to be putting it in my tear ducts. Now I'm going to take my brown lip liner. I'm going to start lining my lips. This liner is from MUA, and I'm also going to be using an MUA lipstick. They're both really cheap, like £1, but they do the job. And I'm going to create like a really nude lip. And I'm done, guys. Like, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you subscribe, you like, and comment. I love you guys. Until next time. Friends are, you gotta let me out of friends are. Friends are, you gotta let me out of friends are. Friends are, you gotta let me out of friends are. Friends are. Fanatics. They call me Simba, will you be my Nala? I have you dripping in Prada. You already know me, no, I know I'm harder. So you can forget all the drama, girl.